We aren't going to get into the nitty-gritty of fuzzy matching here, but so you understand how fuzzy matching works, it looks at words and calculates a closeness of match score based on the similarity of these words. You can find some basic information about two of the most popular algorithms used in fuzzy matching in the notes below the video.
When we fuzzy match two datasets together, the best practice is to use a sort of waterfall approach where we go from most accurate matches down to least accurate matches. The first thing we want to do is actually join the two datasets to identify the records that do match perfectly together, and then remove those records from the mix so that we can start fuzzy matching the rest of the records. We need to select fields that we believe will identify the records uniquely, like using their first name, last name, and address fields. With the exact match records removed from the whole dataset, we then need to decide on the different set of fields we want to fuzzy match on. For example, if we're working with customers, we may have their first name, last name, address, city, state, zip, phone number, and even their email. Using different combinations of these fields, we can build out fuzzy matching approaches. For instance, we might want to start with just first name, last name, address, and zip code. For the remaining records that did not match, we might want to try first name, last name, and phone number. For the remaining records that didn't match again, maybe we'll try just last name and address. Each time we're trying to find some duplicates, code them with the methodology used to match them, and then remove them from the set until we have exhausted all matching methods. The remaining records must be considered to be non-duplicates.